independently. Once I'm airborne, I'll use all three controls in a coordinated way.
Okay.
Turn us back towards the ridge, okay? And then we can fly along the ridge, or you can fly along the ridge, okay?
Okay.
Right, so what was I going to do? I was going to do adverse yaw with you, wasn't I?
Yes.
Okay. So, actually, we'll use the sun for this, okay?
Okay.
So, adverse yaw, what I want you to do is I want you to follow through on the stick and the rudder pedals, okay?
Yeah.
And what I've got is, what I'm going to show you is I'm going to turn the glider to the right, okay?
Okay.
But I'm not going to use the rudder. I'm just going to use the ailerons. Now, I'm pointing the glider at the moment. You see the nose of the glider is pointing towards the sun?
Yeah.
Okay? Now, I'm going to turn to the right, so I need to have a good look out to the right, as far around as I can. I'll check there's no one there, and then I head over the nose again. Follow through on the controls. Okay, now watch what happens when I move the stick to the right without moving the rudder. I want you to tell me which way the nose swings. Which way did the nose swing?
Left.
Okay, now, that's adverse yaw. Okay, and that's caused by the, extra drag created on the left wing.
Yes.
Okay, so a little bit of it, starts to pull that the left wing backwards and not the right wing. Okay, I'm just going to turn the glider. Take us back along the ridge here, okay? Okay, so that's adverse yaw. So to counteract that effect, okay?
Yeah.
Gosh, that is beautiful, isn't it? Look at that. What a sight. To counteract that effect, what I need to do is I need to use the aileron in conjunction with the rudder, okay? So I'm going to turn the glider to the left, okay?
Okay.
Follow through on the stick and the rudder. Okay, now we need to, because we're going to turn to the left, both of us need to look round to the left and check there's nothing there, okay?
Okay.
Okay, then look ahead over the nose again. Now follow through, okay? Now I'm going to move stick and rudder to the left. Left wing goes down, it continues to go down until I centralise the stick. Then I apply slight backward pressure to the stick and reduce the amount of rudder a bit. So the glider's now banked and turning, okay?
Yes.
All right. So now whilst we're in the, notice as we're getting the turn how the nose moves steadily around the horizon. And the relationship between the nose and the glider and the horizon remains constant, okay?
Yes.
Yep. Okay, so to come out of the turn, I also need to look out in the direction of the turn because other gliders may have come to join me. So to come out of the turn, I need to look round to the right, above and below the wing, check there's nobody there, then look ahead again over the nose, and then I move stick and rudder to the right. When the wings are level, I centralise the rudder and relax the backward pressure on the stick. Okay?
Yeah.
Alright, so that's a full turn. Attitude is constant, speed is steady, you have control.
I'd like you
to try a turn to the right. Okay? So look round first, then ahead over the nose, and then move stick and rudder to the right. Great. And just now keep us going round in this turn. Okay. That's lovely. See the string in front of you. Try and keep that string in the middle. So a little bit of left rudder, and that string will go into the middle a bit more. Okay? So did anyone tell you about that string?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I have control.
You have control.
Right. Okay. So I'm just going to fly the glider over this way a bit, okay? Down back towards the airfield a bit. So that string is basically showing you what the airstream is doing over the glider. Okay, sorry, that was my DV panel, okay?
Okay.
So, I'm just going to fly us along the ridge myself for a bit because I want to get us a little more height if we can. Because we're down at 800 feet, okay? So that string is telling you what the airflow is doing over the glider. So you see how it's nice and straight at the moment?
Yeah.
Okay? So, now I'm going to turn the glider to the left, okay? But in turning the glider to the left, watch what happens with the string. So follow through on the controls, okay? On the stick and rudder, okay? And then watch what happens with the string as I turn the glider to the left, okay? So I'm gonna go left now. Okay. And I'm gonna straighten the glider up now. So what happened with the string?
It went right.
Yeah. Was it a lot of right or was it a little bit of right?
Sort of half.
To me it would look pretty much straight down the... pretty much. So I'm going to go right again now, so I'm going to look round. So to the right. Pretty much trying to keep it mostly in the centre there, isn't it?
Yeah.
So what you were doing in your turn, what you were doing is you were going left, but you actually had too much rudder. You see the string is going right the wrong way?
Yeah.
Okay, so I just reduce the amount of rudder a bit and the string goes back to the middle. Okay?
Okay.
Alright, you have control.
I have control.
I want you to turn the glider to the right now. Going around. Now I want you to straighten the glider up. So look out to the left, check there's nobody there. Then look ahead over the nose, then straighten the glider up, okay? And get the string back in the middle, just centralise the rudder, okay? That's great. Okay, so I want you to fly it along the ridge. If you can fly it about 47 knots, that would be great. Did you do any speed control stuff on your last flight?
No.
Okay. So as long as the ridge is working, what I'm going to do in a minute is give you a demonstration of the rudder doesn't turn the glider, okay?
Okay.
All right. So if you can just keep us flying for a bit along the ridge, see if we can get a few more feet again, because this demonstration's going to lose us a lot of height, okay?
Yeah.
And I want to make sure that we got as much height as possible before we start this, okay? So ease it left a little bit, the glider. Don't forget to look out before you do. See, there's a glider out to the left.
Yes.
So turn the glider to the left. Not too slow, lower the nose. That's it. Straighten up now. Get the string in the middle, that's great. Okay. Right, I have control.
You have control.
Right, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to give you this demonstration. You see that? You see there's a road down there on our right hand side?
Yes.
Right, I want you to follow through on the rudder pedals. Only on the rudder pedals, not on the stick.
Okay.
Right, now notice we're flying along and we're running parallel to that road. Now, if I want to turn the glider to the left and I only use the rudder, watch what happens. So we're still flying along the ridge, aren't we? Yeah, the glider is flying sideways and we're in a huge amount of sink now. Okay, see how we're just flying parallel to that road still?
Yeah,
still going along the ridge. To straighten up, what I need to do, centralise the rudder. So to turn the glider, I need to use aileron in conjunction with rudder. Now we're actually getting a bit low now, so I'm going to have to go and land, okay?
Okay.
All right. So to turn the glider, I need to use aileron in conjunction with rudder. Okay, so I need to go turn the, I'll turn the glider to the right in a minute, once I need to turn downwind, okay? So I need to make sure I'm having a good lookout, okay? So good lookout, I'm going to go to the right. So I turn the glider to the right, look ahead over the nose now, before I turn, and it follow through on the stick and rudder, and it's stick and rudder to the right, okay? And then I centralise stick and rudder when the wings are level, okay? You have control.
I have control.
I want you to fly it just down the length of the airfield here, okay? Keep us flying downwind. Now I'd like you to fly it at 50 knots if you can. So turn it left a tiny bit. Okay, so a little bit left. Okay, so a little bit close to the airfield, you see. Right, I have control.
You have control.
Right, what I need to do is move the glider out a bit and just get that, get us in a good position to go and land, okay? Right, so that's good. Okay, so what I'm going to do is turn it back towards the airfield. Lower, get my approach speed on, 65 knots. Okay, make sure that I'm trimmed for 65 knots. Okay, and I'm on the circuit now, okay? I'm maintaining my speed as we go around the circuit. Turning onto my base leg. I'm now turning onto my finals. Maintaining my approach speed, opening the air brakes, and then we'll approach down, having a good look out as we go. Plenty of air brakes, going to be able to get a bit rough here, okay?